Hey team, Pooley again. In this episode, I'm gonna show you real quick how I used to use, not this much these days, but how I used to use the song mode in my MPC. And it's basically a chain of patterns. And it will mean like you would start, I would actually start off with one main sequence with all the elements in there and basically copy the sequence, cut some stuff out, put some fill-ins in there. A really complex work, and just remember on the tiny display. Just want to show you what it looks like in the song view. And I went through my old zip disk and I found the arrangement of Higgledy Piggledy, but actually not the original version, the updated version from 2004. Anyway, so I'm happy it loaded the zip drive, and here's the arrangement, and you can kind of get an idea how this works by having a look on the special monitor view. Actually quite fast as well. I don't know what I was thinking. So bottom left, you can see the sequence that changed. So it's already on step two, different sequence. Each sequence is 8 bars long, and you can see like different elements coming in. Actually, what you could do also, like in the edit function of the sequence edit function, you can change the filter and the pitch of sound. So you can create this kind of filter movement in there. It's pretty basic, but you know, the filter sounds are amazing in the MPC. So I would use that a lot, on even on drum sounds. You can hear the main sample now fading in. Filter opening here. So you could see, I mean, what you actually can't see, it's a lot of work, and it's you would really need to learn a machine how it works and everything to be faster with it. But in the end, maybe it's true or it's not true, but I'm convinced that all in all, the way it's programmed and the sequencer is working, it's just more groovy, more funky. I don't know how to explain it. If I would do the same thing in a modern DAW, it would definitely sound a bit more sterile and a bit, yeah, not so funky at all. And it's amazing. It's even now when I hear it after so many years, just raw like this with no effects on there and everything, it sounds really, really good. And you think like in every sequence or in every part, it's shifting a little bit, and yeah, it's amazing. So song mode, a lot of work, but I think it pays off in the end. I'm just gonna show you real quick how I would integrate my synthesizers into the MPC, and I played a really, really simple thing on top of this main track, and I can show you real quick and then I explain you. So it's a sequence here. So basically, you can see in the bottom left, Juno 106, so channel 15 on the B output for MIDI. I have, for all the machines, I have a special output dedicated. So here there's the Matrix, the S5000, I think, yeah, there's the Kawaii. And then on A, I have the Jupiters and the Mini Moogs. So yeah, let's go back to the Juno 106. I'm gonna play to you first and then I explain you a little bit more. Like this, you can hear it a little bit better. So what I really like about using the MPC as a sequencer for all the synthesizers as well, you can hear it's the same kind of swing to it and everything. And I also think that when you use the MPC as a sequencer, you play all your sounds a little bit different. It's just a bit more, it suits better for house and techno. I think it's just like, it's a bit more simple, I would say, but also shorter, more stabby and everything. So both for harmonies or for bass lines and everything. And what I would do, I just would let it play and record the Juno while changing the sound a little bit, like with LFO, for example. So, again, I would do like a long take, 2 or 3 minutes, and you know, just let like an 8-bar or 16-bar sequence play and record later to the door just to have it stored and just do minor changes. But like the whole, the way it's programmed and everything, the approach, I still, to this day, I prefer to program everything into the MPC. And okay, sometimes it's pretty hard if you have long pads and you want to cut them the right way or you want to have them loop perfectly. You have to be really precise when you're playing it, but I think it just sounds way better. Another feature on my MPC, what I'm using all the time, is it's called simultaneous sequence. It basically means like you're playing a sequence and another one sequence is playing at the same time. And it's really useful for when, for example, you have you're doing a like kind of a techno-y basic track, and this is like 4 bars, for example, and you want to have like one sound on top that changes all the time, and that might be like 32 bars long. So basically, you let that 4-bar sequence play the whole time, and at the same time the longer one with, I don't know, like a synthesizer sound or something is playing at the same time. And it's also, it could be really interesting for things to shift a little bit. And that's what I did. I just did it really quickly now. Basically, I have the sequence from the previous track, and the Juno I had programmed in before, I put on a new sequence, and I changed that sequence to 3/4 of a bar, so it's shifting the whole time. And if you will see on the monitor now that it's shifting, and the normal sequence with the beats and everything is staying the same. So if you look on the bottom left, it only goes to 3. Yeah, really useful. It's constantly shifting and gives some nice effects, especially when you're doing a long take or something. So thanks for watching again, and I hope you enjoyed it.